So your question is, how does somebody wake up from the dream or called Maya? Okay, so Maya is nothing but the mind only. Without there's no mind, there's no Maya. In deep sleep, okay, mind is in a rudiment, mind is in a some dormant condition. There is no Maya. There's a feeling of bliss, experience of bliss. So when you wake up, the world gets projected, and the projection appears to be very real. And you are appearing as an experiencer of the world. So there is a duality. I am the experiencer, the world is there. So now what happens? What is the process of waking? Waking up is people think a lot of process possibilities are there. This yoga, that yoga and all. Ultimately in Atmadnana, simply Atmadnana is because of the teaching. Teaching of Vedantic teaching in given name. Systematic way. And this systematic way is called prakriya. In each of these prakriya, various belief systems of the mind is exposed. Wrong understanding of the mind is exposed. Right? For example, somebody saw a snake on the road and he started crying, snake, snake, snake. Another person comes and flashes a light on the snake and finds it's a rope. So basically you are exposing your mental beliefs. So in the process of jnana, through various prakriyas, the guru exposes different wrong beliefs which you have. As wrong beliefs start coming down, the mind becomes free. And the deep innermost wrong belief that I am the body also starts dissolving because of the teaching. So this is a process of dissolving or removing the belief systems of the mind by right teaching called prakriyas. Okay, then this also is a method. The teaching is in a sense a questioning who am I, finding out who real I am. Now it's not repeating who am I many times. It is inquiring into my own belief systems and dropping wrong belief systems. And when the wrongs are dropped, then what remains is the self. It's basically removing the wrong belief systems through a process of questioning or process of teaching. That's how somebody wakes up.
But she asked, who is the one who comes and wakes up?
No, the one who comes and wakes, who comes and wakes up is the master, guru. It can be a situation. It can be an event in life which may suddenly wake you up drastically. Okay. See, ultimately, all of us are, there is no other, there is only Brahman, there is only pure consciousness. Everything is a dream reality. So, many times people go through a certain tremendous amount of stress in life. Okay. Because of circumstance. So, then whatever reality they think starts collapsing. For example, somebody is married happily. Okay, they think that happy marriage is the ultimate in life. The person may divorce and go, or may person may die. So all these situations open up, break certain traditional realities, and something you don't have to hold. You will not be left with anything to hold on. In such a situation, person wants to come out of that mess in life or difficulty, challenge in life. So then he may start seeking a teaching in whatever form. So the teaching comes in the form of Vedantic teaching, where Atmadnana, a process of inquiry into the nature of self, which is systematically exposed the belief system what you have. And finally, you will come to get a clarity on the real nature of life, real nature of self and real nature of the world. So this is how it happens. And the teaching is called grace. Okay, the teaching is called grace because what is reality is not in your worldview. It can't learn from your society. The teaching has to be given in certain systematic way. So the teaching by the master is called grace. The teaching is an intervention in your life. Like when you have a disease, you go to your doctor and doctor will do some medicine. It's called intervention in your life. And doctor's medicine is not in your hand, his knowledge. Like that, guru's teaching is a specialized knowledge or wisdom which intervenes in your life based on your seeking. It's not that guru will come into your life, and when you start seeking it, seeking knowingly, unknowingly, you start getting that. That's the grace. So what is the question now? Their parallel.
And there's a possibility.
See, the prarabdha karma and
something like it is going parallel. What is the thing which
means? Yeah, yeah. See, prarabdha karma and grace is always there. Okay, they are parallel. Okay? But you don't seek grace. Because
there's something prarabdha force which is shifting over there, which is making that even though there's grace 24 hours.
Yeah.
It,
see.
He doesn't seek it.
Okay. See, you can take the world instead of taking it as a Maya. Okay. You can take it as a game. Okay. In the sense, you can take. When we call the world as Maya. Okay. It's an appearance. But you can also call this virtual reality game, VR game, virtual reality, where there are certain set of rules are there, some regulations are there, you play, and you play to win, right? In life also you play to win, okay? That's how you do. So there are some plus points and there are some minus points in a game. So what you call bonus points and minus points. Life also has a bonus point called karma plus points and karma minus points, which is actually good karma and bad karma. So, person is constantly struggling to win the game. Okay, that's how the game proceeds. A point will come in the game where no matter what he tries to do, he is not able to win the game, and he understands there is a limitation in his ability to play the game. That is after he has exhausted all playing mechanisms and after learning has happened. So then he starts seeking the help of an expert, somebody who can help him to come out of the game or learn something better. That's very intervention. So if you call the game as a virtual reality, experience the game and playing the game you call as prarabdha karma, and the karma as a points, plus points and minus points which you get in a game, virtual reality game. And at certain point he gets frustrated, I'm not able to win the game, I have to come out. Then he seeks the grace. Whereas the grace or the master is also already there, available at any point of time. But he doesn't seek because he is so engrossed in the game. The game is designed in such a way that eventually somebody will get frustrated. It's not that game is perpetually is joyful. So the game has a lot of ups and downs and plus points and minus points, twists and turns, game of Maya. So the game of Maya is designed in such a way that it'll always there to wake you up. At some point of time, you start waking up from the game, and that time you seek the grace.
But he seeks the grace, and then we get a grace. But when does that click happen?
Click of what?
Something is parallel is going on, grace is going on.
That's what I'm saying. The grace is always there, the game is also always there. Okay, grace and game are parallel.
Yeah, but at one point, there's some frustration over there.
Yeah, the point of frustration will, the two things will happen. The game of life or called Maya, always some reward points, plus points called good merit, good punya, and also some negative points called papa or which can cause suffering. Punya causes joy and papa causes suffering. And person always playing for getting a good merit. Everybody is also always trying to get some happiness in whatever way. Life is designed in such a way that twists and turns. The game is not any game, like a video game also has multiple levels. The twists and turns of game, at some point in time he will flip over. He is not able to, or rather whatever his understanding of the game, there's so much of frustration. Okay? So either boredom also you can say, boredom, frustration, whatever is that. and that point is individual, which point he gets boredom, frustration, and which point he starts seeking a solution is his apparent choice. It's a part of prarabdha karma. And that part of time, he wants to come out of the game. The grace which is always available, he seeks. And that helps him to get out. That's what I'm saying. The prarabdha karma is life. You can take maya as a game.
Yeah.
In the game, he's coming and he has a free will, apparent free will, and he plays it. He plays to win. Okay? He doesn't know it's a game.
Yeah.
He has got involved in that. So then, at certain point of time, it comes to a point he is no longer able to win or he gets frustrated. Then he seeks, I want to get out. Or he may do some lot of good karma, which will help him to become better, 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 and which he wants to come out through jnana. Yeah, prarabdha karma means what I have done with my apparent free will. See, all this you have to use the word apparent. In virtual reality game, whatever you do is not real from the absolute point of view. But for the person who is playing, it's real only. So in that, he has apparent freedom. In that apparent freedom, he has a creation of karma and he has apparent points. Okay, we should not mix up the two, this thing. If you speak from the maya world, there is an apparent freedom for you. From the point of view of maya world. In this domain, you have freedom right now. You are feeling apparent freedom, feeling of freedom. Or rather, see, we should not mix the two views. Ramana Maharshi's view is a Jnani's view. Okay? So Jnani's view is there to guide you to get out of what you are. But it's not your reality. Okay? See, there are different viewpoints of life. Somebody is going in a boat. For him, a tree is approaching. Okay? But person who is standing near the tree, boat is approaching. Right? So the viewpoints are different. Ramana Maharshi's viewpoint is a Jnani's viewpoint. From Jnani's viewpoint, he says everything is unreal. Everything is like a dream. You don't have freedom. Okay? From a person who is in the maya, for him he has a freedom. He doesn't know this viewpoint. So he is trying to struggle and come out. Okay? For him, Ramana Maharshi is trying to tell, only when he comes to Ramana Maharshi, that you are going through a dream world. In the dream world, there is no freedom. You come out of the dream. For that, the teaching. So now you cannot mix the teaching. For a person who is, day to day he says, I am free. He is going through life as if he is free. In that as if freedom, he will discover a freedom. Finally, he will come to a point, the freedom, only real freedom comes from jnana. At that point of time, he starts getting jnana. So you cannot mix up the two viewpoints. Now you are listening to Ramana Maharshi because you have come to a point where you are ready to listen to Ramana Maharshi. This doesn't apply to somebody who is not ready to listen to Ramana Maharshi. He is happy with the game. Right? This is true for somebody who is playing a video game. A child is playing a video game. Mother calls, he won't come up. Okay? He will not come. He is so involved in the game. But at certain point of time, he is losing the game. Then mother calls, he will suddenly wake up. What the hell is this game? He will come out. So, this is how it happens. This is actually what you can say, it's a leela. This is called, the world is called leela or maya. Leela means it's a game only. Maya means virtual reality. In the modern language, you have to say it's more like a virtual reality game. So, you're so engrossed in the game. You want to play. You want to win. Okay? At some point, you get so frustrated. Then somebody calls and says, no, come out. Then you'll come out. Then, all your frustration, you say, okay, all this is a game, Baba, don't worry, you come out. This is the teaching. So you cannot mix up the teachings. See, this teaching of that everything is a maya or a dream will help you to wake up. It doesn't help to somebody who thinks it's real. Where is the question? So what was the question? Where did you start?